keep your feet hip distance, press your heels down as far as they go, head between the elbows, sit bones high, engage your core. So coming up with one leg through, feel that stretch, opening the hip, gently just roll it in to a pigeon position. So find that leg through the back leg, big inhale, so you're keeping your position here, for your hips, knee out to an angle, draw into your core, squeeze into that back leg, gently send it forward, really relax through your back. Exhale here, you can just maybe feel what's going on, so if you need to stretch more towards the right or more towards the left, we can combine to loosen off through and find that good sweet spot stretch using the strength of the upper body. Engage with the core, push, come back to your downward facing dog, push the hips up, so you're going to lift up to the other leg, feel that stretch. Gently just draw the knee between the two thumbs onto the side and find length. So you can start here a little bit more. Find length. You can even do it this way. And once you feel a little bit more competent, just roll onto your hips this way. The first time I did this, it did feel strange. So if it's your first time doing it and it feels strange, don't worry. Squeezing into the back, drawing into your core. Let your breath come and go to feel the release of your body. Slowly walk it forward. How much do we dare to let those elbows go down? Trust me, with each breath, just exhale, get lower and lower. So it's all interconnected with your hips and your back. So if you feel a little bit in your back here, that is so normal. Stretching out through those hips, exhale. So use the strength of the upper body, engage through the core, you're gonna push up, you're gonna lift. Your downward facing dog. Big inhale, exhale. Well done, excellent job.